Well, Godzilla vs. Kong. It's a film I was extremely excited for, and I had no reason to believe it would disappoint, as I loved the previous Kong Godzilla films. And the movie has a great soundtrack, at times it looks phenomenal, and the concept was absolutely awesome. I had no doubt in my mind that this would be a solid contender for Film of the Year. There are, however, issues that plague this film from the very start. The audio quality was wonky, and I could barely hear what the characters said even after changing the settings on my TV, and some special effects were a little overblown and not very good. Now, before I go deep into this movie, I have to address those who defend it adamantly. I'm certain that the consensus on this movie is mostly positive, but at the same time, the thing I hear from fans is, quote, "It's not about the characters, it's about the monsters," which I normally would agree with, but this case is far different, so to explain why that defense doesn't work, I must first explain what's so wrong with the characters and story. Well, first off, the storyline involving Millie Bobby Brown is straight up unnecessary and horrendous. Her father has a role that barely serves a purpose, the conspiracy theorist she works with is annoying, and she adds nothing to the film as a character. And the concepts are absolutely ridiculous in this storyline, like how the reasoning for Godzilla's rampage is supposed to be that he's mad at the creation of Mechagodzilla, which makes it hard to believe that his main target is Kong. I understand Kong is trying to stop Godzilla with the humans, but would Godzilla rather destroy the thing he hates or go after some monkey? Plus, there's no way Godzilla would know that Kong's working with the humans to stop him, so why does he even go after him whatsoever? Plus, why does he attack the Florida facility instead of the Hong Kong one, since that's the one where Mechagodzilla's being built? And the other storyline is also quite bad. None of the characters are very fleshed out besides the little girl, who was really one of the few interesting parts of the movie. Nobody in either storyline has some trauma or backstory that makes them worthy of your tears or goosebumps. The conspiracy theorist has a dead wife, but it's not like we get a good enough performance or flashbacks that make that story worth a damn. Not to mention the Hollow Earth part, which looks cool, but it makes one short appearance that serves one simple purpose: to give Kong the axe. Okay, the axe is flat out stupid, and once again doesn't feel fleshed out. Not to mention, the entire concept of Hollow Earth is extremely forced, because I find it somewhat crazy that nobody has gone down to Hollow Earth, yet these random scientists just know where it is. Everything has mountains of stupidity, convenience, and lack of detail that wrecks the story as a whole. So now let's get back to the defense of this movie. Those who like it say that all that matters is the monster fight, which is reasonable, but guess what? Guess what? It has only two monster fights. Only two. That right there is bad enough, but take into account the fact that none of the story is good or fleshed out, and the film is only 90 minutes because the movie juggles so many ridiculous moments at once. It's an unbalanced, horribly written film that completely destroys the great setup of its concepts and previous films. While the first Godzilla vs. Kong fight is the highlight of the movie, the final fight is ridiculous because of one major reason. Godzilla spares Kong. I get that they can't have one kill the other, which, yeah, but then don't have Godzilla knock Kong down, right? Just for him to suddenly change his mind and have him go after Mechagodzilla, which should have been his entire target the whole movie. Not to mention, there are tons of ridiculous cliches, such as one of the members to the Hollow Earth expedition being supposedly greedy and evil, but she dies 3 minutes later, so what's even the point? I get that the main idea is to see Kong and Godzilla fight, but when there are only two fights in the whole movie, I find it pathetic. Ridiculous convenience, stupid character actions, awful characters in general, okay special effects at best, a horrific story, and a lack of real action gives this the title of the most disappointing movie I've ever seen. My score is not a zero, but it isn't a three. I give this mound of dung a 1.5 out of 5. I'm heavily, heavily enraged.